Welcome, dear students. Welcome to the chapter Polymers of your part 2 book. This is chapter number 15, where today we will be learning in this chapter about different polymers and what are polymers, what the word polymer mainly tells us about. So the polymer, the word starts from macromolecules firstly. So polymers, they are made up of very large molecules which have very high molecular mass. Means when the molecular mass exceeds 10 to the power 2, means from more than 100 units, the range of this molecular mass, it lies between 10 to the power 3 to 10 to the power 7 units. So when these different macromolecules combine, they are known as polymers. Now, the single unit of a polymeric chain means, as I said, that polymers means a large number of macromolecules are combining. So a single macromolecule, that is known as a monomer. And the process of formation of this polymers from the respective monomers, that is known as polymerization. Means in case of polymerization, when certain number of macromolecules, where these macromolecules are those compounds which have very high molecular masses, they are combining together to form a polymer, that process is known as polymerization. One example is given here. Here you see ethene molecule, n number of ethene molecule, it is combining to form polyethene polymer. And similarly, hexamethyl diamine, it is combining with adipic acid to form nylon 66. Then moving ahead, we will be looking at the classification of these polymers. This is a very short chapter actually. Here only the classification is there in your syllabus at present. So firstly, the classification of polymer, it is based on the source of the polymers. Source means from where these polymers actually are derived. It is either natural, it is semi-synthetic or synthetic. Then let us see one by one. The first one is natural polymers. Now these polymers are those which are found in plants or animals, where examples are this protein, cellulose, starch, etc. Next one comes the semi-synthetic one. The semi-synthetic one means we have to take the precursor from plants and we will be making a small change in that, and then that is known as semi-synthetic polymers. And in this polymers, there are rayons and cellulose nitrate, etc. Means here the precursor which is used, from where it is synthesized, that comes from plants or animals. The last one is synthetic polymers. In case of synthetic polymers, means it is directly man-made with the help of some chemicals. Here no precursor is used from the natural polymers. And in this case, we have this Buna S. And man-made polymers, these are mainly extensively used in daily life to these days. Then there are nylon 66, polyethylene, etc. All these are all synthetic polymers. Another way of classification of these elements, these polymers, it is based on their structure of polymers. Means what is the structure of these polymers? Based on that also polymers are classified. So if we are to look into them one by one, the first one is linear polymers on structure. Here in this case, the polymers, they consist of long and straight chain, means no branching is there in this case. The examples of these polymers are high density polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride, which we know as PVC, etc. And the basic representation for them is in this way, means they are of straight chain compounds, nothing is there. And the next one which comes here, it is the branch chain polymers. And in this polymers, what will happen, this long chain will be there, along with that some chains will come out from this. The actual representation is something in this way, means some straight chains will be there, and from that straight chain some branch will come out. And for this, the examples are low density polyethylene, etc. The next one is the cross-linked or the network polymers. Here they are formed from bifunctional and trifunctional monomers. Bifunctional and trifunctional monomers means these macromolecules, these polymers, they are formed by those macromolecules where the macromolecules contain different functional group. Now, different functional group means one will have either the OH functional group, the other will have NH functional group, nitro functional group, or NH2 functional group. Means in both the cases, the functional group is different here in this cross-linked network polymers, and the representation of these polymers, it is given in this way, where some straight chains are there. This the means it is something uneven type, and this is mainly seen in bakelite, melamine, etc. And these polymers, they are depicted as shown here. Next one is the example of addition polymers. Now, what are addition polymers? We will be knowing about them here. That in case of addition polymers, as the name signifies here, means how the polymerization is occurring. Till now, first was we classified it on the base of their source. Next one, we classified on the base of their structure. And now these classifications are the mode of polymerization. Mode of polymerization means how the polymerization is occurring. Means in which way the polymerization is occurring. Here you can see the definition is written here. The addition of polymers, it is formed by repeated units of monomer which pose double and triple bonds, and when these double and triple bond they combine, these means addition polymers are formed. These polymers are formed by addition of two different polymers, and these polymers are known as copolymers. Here example is given. You see here this ethene molecule, it had double bond, and these all they combine together and they form a polyethene. And the polymers made by addition polymerization from two different monomers are known as copolymers, and when this same molecule is repeated again and again, they are known as homopolymer. Here you see these two molecules are different. One is butadiene, another one is styrene. Styrene and butadiene, when these two are combining, the compound that is formed, this is different again. So this type of compound where the precursors are two different molecules, then that is known as copolymer, and when the precursor is a single molecule, then that is known as a homopolymer. Then another one is condensation polymers. This is also another type where this polymerization is occurring through condensation. And how this condensation is occurring, it is formed by repeated condensation between two different bifunctional. Once again, this bifunctional is coming here. Now you will get the idea when I'll write this. You see here that in case of bifunctional, you see one is having this NH2 group, and here you can see this is having a COOH group. So this type of compounds, they are known as bifunctional groups. So when these type of bifunctional groups combine together by repeated condensation, the compound formed, it will form through the elimination of water. So this type of polymers are known as this type of means formation of polymers are known as condensation polymers. And in condensation polymers, the most common example is nylon 6,6. The next one is the classification of these polymers based on the molecular forces. Now molecular forces means how these molecules are attaching to each other. I mean, so in what way they are attached to each other, through which forces. Here first one, you can see a large number of polymers which are applied in different fields. They are means some are very rough, some are very soft, some are very elastic. So how these polymers are formed, about that we'll be discussing here. That first one is elastomers. Then in case of elastomers, what happens here, elastomers, they are rubber like solids which have elastic properties. These are rubbers which have elastic properties, and they are also known as elastomeric polymers. In case of elastomeric polymers, we have the example of neoprene. And what is neoprene, if you can get idea, this is a neoprene. Here in case of neoprene, what happens, there is a cross link is introduced in between the chains which help the polymer to retract to its original position after the force is released, as in vulcanized rubber. This is an example of Buna-S, neoprene, etc. These are certain examples for this one. Then the next one are fibers. Now fibers, they are thread forming solids. Means these are those solids which will form thread, and they have very high tensile strength, and high the modulus is also very high. The characteristic is due to the strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding. Means in this case, hydrogen bonding is very strong here. And they also, these strong forces, due to this, they have a crystalline nature, and the examples are this polyamides, sterilene, etc. And then the next one is the thermoplastic polymers. Now, in case of fibers, we have those compounds which have bifunctional group, which have bifunctional groups, and in those bifunctional groups, hydrogen bonding becomes very strong. As in case of NH and CO molecule, it will be very strong. In case of thermoplastic, here comes the PVC, polyvinyl chloride, and here polyvinyl chloride, we have the famous example of polythene, polystyrene, etc. Here, the linear or the slightly branched long chain molecules, they are capable of repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling. Means these solids, means these polymers, once if heated, they will become soft, and once again they cooled, they become hard. So these type of polymers are known as thermosetting polymers, and this is an example of PVC, polyvinyl chloride, and this is example of thermoplastic polymers. The last one is thermosetting polymers. In case of thermosetting polymers, what happens? These polymers are cross-linked between heavily branched molecules. Heavily branched molecule means they will be, you can see this one, they are between very heavily branched molecules here. Heavily branched molecules means you can see here this CH2 is linking between these two heavily branched molecules. So this type of compounds are known as thermosetting polymers. Now next comes the classification, which is based on the growth polymers. Growth polymers means how the polymerization proceeds depending upon the number of steps and how, what are the monomers included in that. Depending upon that, it is classified. So here the mainly two broad classifications are there. The classifications are addition or chain growth, or condensation or the step growth polymerization. Now here, first one is the addition polymerization or the chain growth polymerization. Now here, this mechanism, the mechanism is also known as the free radical mechanism. Here what happens that the same monomer, means here the polymerization is occurring between same monomer, or it can be different also in some cases, but they add together in large scale, means very high number of monomers, they come together and they form the polymer. And these monomers which are used, they are usually unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated means they have double bonds in them. And this mode of polymerization, it slowly increases the, means the chain, and at last it terminates. Means mainly three steps are here. The first step is the chain initiating step, the next one is chain propagating step, and the last one is the chain terminating step. We'll be looking into them one by one now. Free radical mechanism, the mechanism, it includes three. Here the polymerization, whatever it is, say that the start, it starts with benzoyl peroxide here, and this is the initiator, and once it is initiated, it attacks a ethene molecule, and that ethene molecule again generates a free radical, and this is the chain initiating step. Then the chain propagation starts, and finally it gets terminated. Now here you need to see that, which is the chain initiation step, chain propagating step. Here you see, this is the polymer. This polymer here, in this case, firstly it homolytic fission occurs. In homolytic fission means both type it breaks in the same way. You see, this bond is broken and this bond is broken. Two molecules of the same is formed. This is represented as CC5, the phenyl radical. Now this phenyl radical, it attacks the ethene molecule. Now if you remember from your class 11th knowledge, if you remember that, what happened, that this double bond, it one breaks, one electron comes here and one electron it goes here. Then this one electron and this one electron, they will form a bond. Means the one electron which is here, it will come here, and this one electron is will come here, and they will form one one bond. This one bond is formed, and this one electron which moved here, it is remained in the system. The next step, again this ethene molecule, once again this one electron will come here and one electron will go here, then this one electron and this one electron, they will be forming one bond. This one bond is formed, and this is the chain propagating step, and final one is the chain terminating step. In case of chain terminating step,
these type of two molecules, they combine, you see, this type two molecule, one look, and these type of two molecules, they combine and they form a long chain, and this is how the polyethylene molecule is formed. This is a chain termination and the free radical mechanism of addition polymerization or chain group polymerization. The preparation of some important addition polymers means some important polymers which are used in our daily life. They are, number one is Teflon. Teflon, it is used in this medicinal industry. Here, this is manufactured by heating this tetrafluoroethene with a free radical of persulfate as a catalyst, and this is chemically inert and it is not corrosive, and means it does not rust, and it is also used in making oil gaskets, means it is used in making gaskets and also used for non-stick cookwares. This is how it is prepared. You see here, this type of two tetrafluoroethene, this is the tetrafluoroethene, this one is tetrafluoroethene. This molecule, this number of molecule, they under the presence of some catalyst and high pressure, they form polymers. Next one is polyacrylonitrile. Polyacrylonitrile is same here, tetracyanide, that cyanide groups are there. These cyanide groups, they also form polymers by this same phenomenon of addition or chain group polymerization. Next one is the condensation polymerization or the step growth polymerization. Here, the main thing is that here the monomers should have two different functional group. Here they should be bifunctional. It is written, it is already said, it generally occurs between two bifunctional monomers. This polycondensation may result in loss, means some molecule will be lost, and like water or alcohol, and finally a bigger molecule is formed. This reaction, the product of each step is again a bifunctional process, means every step one bifunctional group will be formed, which will be more clear if you see one example. You see here, this is an example. Here, this is one functional group and this is another functional group. When these two will combine, this type of compound, this type of compound will form here, and this will continue until and unless we get our desired product. Next are the polyamides, and now these polyamides, they are formed as a result of this step growth or condensation polymerization. Here, this polymer, they possess amide linkages. Now, amide linkages means CO and NH linkages. The general method is same as condensation polymerization. Here, the preparation of nylon is also done in the same way, nylon 6,6. It is prepared by condensation polymerization by this one, you see. Now these reactions you need to by heart by writing. Here this hexamethylene diamine, it is treated with adipic acid under high pressure and very high temperature, and the product yielded is nylon 6,6. And this nylon 6,6, it is making used in making sheets, bristle for brushes, and textile industry. Next one is nylon 6. Nylon 6 is used by heating caprolactam with water. Now this is a caprolactam molecule where bifunctional group of this carbonyl means this carbonyl, one functional group is this one functional group is this one. Bifunctional group, when they combine under the presence of heat, then they will form this nylon 6. Now nylon 6, it is used in making tire fabrics and also in the making of ropes. Now, preparation of polyesters. Now, polyesters we are very familiar with because Dacron, Terylene, these are all polyesters. Now, these polyesters, they are also formed by condensation. Condensation means same compound will have some poly from bifunctional group and they will condense together. Dacron or Terylene, as I already said, in the presence of zinc. Now, this is crease resistance, means they normally they do not get this creases or linkages in them. And this is used in cotton and wool fibers and also as glass reinforcing materials and safety helmets. Now, preparation of phenol formaldehyde polymer bakelite. Bakelite means those which are used in these handles of the cooking wares. Here is also known as formaldehyde polymer because the formaldehyde molecule is used along with phenol. So, phenol formaldehyde polymer, these are the oldest synthetic polymers. These all come under the synthetic polymers. Here they are obtained by the condensation of phenol with formaldehyde. and the reaction which is given, this is the complete reaction, and where finally you can see the novel lac is formed. And this compound, this big compound, this is novel lac. And this novel lac, it is used in making combs, phonograph, records, electric switch, and all this big polymer of novel lac is used. Now this novel lac, it is prepared by using this phenol along with formaldehyde with different steps. You can see one step, this formaldehyde is obtained, and after that this one, means every step this CH2OH group, it is adding. You can see here, you see it, this CH2OH group, this one is getting added in this phenol group. Finally, this CH2OH group, when number of CH2OH group in this way they combine, then they will form this type of long chain compound, which is known as novolac, and this is a result of condensation polymerization. Novolac, this on hitting with formaldehyde, they undergo cross-linking. Cross-linking in the same way here, how it was formed. This is cross-linking polymer. Now it is used in making various utensils. This is bakelite. This novolac on heating, they form bakelite. This bakelite, it is used for making combs and all. Now last one is the melamine formaldehyde polymer. Melamine, this is a melamine formaldehyde. It is formed by condensation of melamine and formaldehyde. Here also this compound is known as melamine. This compound is known as melamine. This one, when condensed with formaldehyde, means reacted with formaldehyde by polymerization, they form this melamine polymer. Now melamine polymer, this is used in the manufacture of unbreakable crockery. Means certain crockeries are there which when fall down, they do not break. So they are used in making those crockeries. Last topic of this chapter is your copolymerization. Now in case of copolymerization, the monomer units that we are using in polymerization, they are different monomer units. Here the notes site is already given to you. Yeah, the monomers, they have two different functional groups here. Means, and also not two different functional groups, means the monomers which are condensing, they are two different monomers. You see here, this is one molecule and this is another molecule. So two different molecules are combining together to form one polymer. So this type of polymers are known as copolymers, and when both of these molecules are same, they are known as homopolymers. Now in case of copolymer, we have rubber. Now natural rubber, one is natural rubber. Rubber is a natural polymer which has elastic properties. It is also termed as elastomers, and it is formed, manufactured from rubber latex, means from the rubber plant, which is a colloidal dispersion. Now it may be considered as linear polymer of isoprene. You can see this is the structure of natural rubber. This is the structure of natural rubber, where the C double bond C, again this one, this is means this is the main linkage. This is the main linkage. Remaining all the units are same. You can see this part is same in every case. You can see C double bond C, H and CH3. Then again C double bond C, H and CH3. You can see this part is same in every case. So this is how this polymer is polymerizing, and this is the structure of natural rubber. Now vulcanization of rubber, here what is seen, that this natural rubber, it becomes very soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature. Brittle means it will break down. This natural rubber, it breaks down at low temperature, but at higher temperature it becomes very soft. So vulcanization means to remove this, remove this property of becoming soft at higher pressure, becoming soft at high temperature and brittle at low temperature. This natural rubber, it is treated with sulfur. This process consists of heating a mixture of raw rubber with sulfur and an appropriate additive at a temperature where the temperature ranges between 373 Kelvin to 415 Kelvin. And on vulcanization, this sulfur, they form cross links at the active sites. Active sites means those molecules which are very reactive, they will link to it. and they form this type of structures. This natural rubber that will form this type of structure when they are treated with sulfur. And once the natural rubber, they form this one, the property of getting hard at low temperature and soft at high temperature, this is removed. So this is known as vulcanization of rubber. Now this preparation of some synthetic rubbers are there. Already I say that semi-synthetic, now we are to synthetic rubber. Then synthetic rubbers, we have neoprene. Then in case of neoprene, we have polychloroprene. Polychloroprene means many chlorine atoms are attached in this one. This is a chloroprene. And when this chloroprene, it is N number, when they are present in N numbers, they are known as neoprene. Now, neoprene is the superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oil. It is used for manufacturing belts and hoses. They are used in manufacturing belts. The last one is Buna N. Now, Buna N, it is already we have studied there about Buna F. Now, here in case of Buna N, we have this butadiene. They are reacted with acrylonitrile. Here, when they are reacted with acrylonitrile, then by the copolymerization, as these two are two different molecules, they are different atoms, so this is known as copolymerization. After this copolymerization, they will form this Buna N. Now, this Buna N, it is the resistance to the action of petrol, lubricating oil, and organic solvent. This is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. This Buna N, they are used for making tank lining seals, etc.
So your last topic is here, biodegradable polymers. So a large number of polymers which are means resistant to environment degradation processes, and they are responsible for the accumulation of polymeric solid waste material. Or ye solid material jo hote hain ye bahut hi zyada matlab environmental problems create karte hain jo ki matlab undegraded rehte hain bahut samay tak ke liye. To general awareness aur concern ke term mein jo problems which are created by the polymeric solid waste, certain new biodegradable synthetic polymers aaye hain. Matlab aise polymers hain jo degrade ho jate hain dheere dheere. To abhi tak piche jo the wo non biodegradable the. Abhi biodegradable polymers mein tumhare dekho ye polybeta hydroxybutyrate, cobuta hydroxyvalerate, jisko hum log PHPV ke naam se jante hain, ye milta hai hame by the copolymerization of 3 hydroxybutanoic acid aur 3 hydroxypentanoic acid. मतलब इन दोनों चीज़ों को जब आपस में रिएक्ट किया जाता है तब जाकर के एक जो पॉलीमर बनता है वो बायोडिग्रेडेबल पॉलीमर होता है. और ये कहाँ काम आता है, स्पेशलिटी पैकेजिंग में, ऑर्थोपेडिक डिवाइसेस में काम आता है, कंट्रोल रिलीज ऑफ ड्रग्स में काम आता है, और ये बैक्टीरियल डिग्रेडेशन होता है. मतलब ये समय के साथ साथ खत्म हो जाता है. इसका रिएक्शन देखो ये है, 3 हाइड्रोक्सी ब्यूटानोइक एसिड. अगर इसका IPOC नेम करो तो देखो 1, 2, 3, तीसरे पोजिशन पर हाइड्रोक्सी ग्रुप है, 3 हाइड्रोक्सी ब्यूटानोइक एसिड और 3 हाइड्रोक्सी पेंटानोइक एसिड. इन दोनों को रिएक्ट करके जो मिलता है इसी को हम PHBV कहते हैं. और ये कुछ इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉमर्शियल इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉलीमर्स हैं जो मतलब कॉमर्शियली इम्पॉर्टेंट मतलब इन्हीं सभी पॉलीमर्स के इन मोनोमर्स की मदद से ये पॉलीमर्स बनाए जाते हैं. बाय द हेल्प ऑफ दीज मोनोमर्स दीज पॉलीमर्स आर मेड एंड दिस इज देयर स्ट्रक्चर एंड दिस इज वेयर दे आर यूज. एंड नॉर्मली फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर 1 mark क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड लाइक where is this polypropene used, or propene एक monomer है तो उससे polymer जो बना वो करो, फिर toys और pipes में किस तरह के monomers लगते हैं, किस तरह के polymers लगते हैं, तो ऐसे पूछे जाते हैं. तो with this we end this chapter here. It's a very short chapter and completely based on theory. So I'll be giving you this notes of this chapter so you can clearly understand it. So thank you for watching the video up to here. Thank you very much.